Hi, I'm Kirsty Meakin from Nao Nails. In this video, we're going to do ballerina shape nails. I'm going to show you how to apply some gorgeous beaded chains, and we're going to do them loop-de-loop. So for this design, we're going to do a ballerina shape nail, or a coffin nail, or a mandel nail. There's a few different names for this shape. It's basically a tapered square, or some people would say it's like a stiletto and it's got the end that's flattened off. So I'm going to pop this form on the same way as I would do for a stiletto nail. So we've got a slight drop. We're going to come to roughly around 3.5 on the numbers. I'm going to use the medium speed acrylic liquid, making sure that's all nice and secure with the clear acrylic. Add a bit of structure to this nail. I've already primed the nail, it's already been prepped. So all I'm doing here is a very thin layer of clear acrylic, just to give us a little bit of structure to work on top of. Keep it nice and thin, nice and smooth. And then we're going to go ahead and use the colours. So we've got soft pastel blue, we have soft pastel green, and metallic green. The metallic green just adds a little bit of intensity. I'm going to take the blue, go right to the cuticle. So nice and neat at the cuticle. And take it down the nail, keeping your sides nice and straight. And I'm placing the soft pastel green on the tip, blending that up a little bit, but mainly concentrating on the tip and getting that nice. And I'm just blending that green up a little bit now. And then on the tip, the very tip, I'm just going to get some of the metallic green, pop that on, quite wet, and just brush that up, and it's just going to make that a little bit brighter. I don't want to use the metallic green on its own because it's too intense. We want to keep it quite pastel. Now I'm just going to pinch it with my fingers a little bit. And then we can use the clear to encapsulate. Make sure you're going all the way over the colour. I'm just going to pinch this down the length of the nail, just to make it really slim. And then I'm going to pop the pinching tool on just to hold that pinch. So I'm going to take off the form. Pulling it down away from the hypernicium. So we're going to do side walls, which is going to do the full length of this nail. You can see that I'm hitting the full length of that nail. Both sides. Cuticle area. Get that nice and flush. Then I'm going to cut for this shape, flatten the end off, and I'm going to go really flat at the sides. Contour the nail. Get all those sexy curves in the right place. You want that apex in the back third of the nail, so that's going to sit around here. When I'm coming over the top here, I'm pulling the file towards me, and you can see that all I touch is actually the lateral length of this nail. I don't touch the apex at the back, so I can make that nice and thin. You can keep those curves in. I'm not going to demolish the apex at the back. Don't forget, this nail is super long, it needs some support. This is going to be worn day to day. This isn't just for show. This nail is not just for show. Our fabulous model, Faye, will be wearing these nails for some weeks. So they need to last. I see people doing nails and taking these beautiful pictures of these wafer thin nails. That won't last 2 minutes. They are just there, just for the photo, and then are taken off. Yes, they look beautiful, but they won't last 5 minutes. They need some support and stability there to last in this, you know, everyday world. Because believe it or not, our model has a job, don't you, Faye? Faye has a job. She has cooking and cleaning to be doing. So she does a lot of things and needs that nail to last. And it'll only do that with the structure and the support. A wafer thin nail will not last her 2 seconds. However, it's nice and thin at the end, you see. Just going to dust that off. I'm going to use the pure acetone lint-free pad, and I'm going to wipe that over and we're going to seal it with Mega Gloss Sealer Gel, and then we will put some gorgeous embellishments on. Put that into the LED lamp for 1 minute. So I've got a selection of embellishments here that we're going to put on. I'm going to use some of this gorgeous chain. I'm going to loop the chain. So it's going to have 3 loops. I'm just going to trim that down with an old pair of cuticle nippers. I need a bit of acrylic, some tweezers, right, so I'm making sure that that acrylic is holding on to the chain. And then, with the other chain, you need a little bit in the middle. Two separate pieces. Now we're going to use a bead here, slightly higher than the ones we did before. Pick up the end, and then we're going to do the same with the other side. So I want to check that they're at the similar height each side. I want it to be as symmetrical as it can. It doesn't need to be completely, but it'll look nicer if it is. I'm just making sure those chains are nice and secure by adding a little bit more acrylic. Woo, that looks really cute. We're going to start to add some crystals. So we're using the acrylic to adhere the crystals. I'm going to add some little blue stones. just going to pop a little bit of the brush on glue onto the micro beads to secure those in place. So that's that nail completely finished. So we've got these dangling chains and your gorgeous crystals and your micro beads. It looks pretty stunning on that shape, I think.